This documentary is all kinds of awesome.
Thank you.
You are welcome.
I'm so happy that it's out there. We've been working on it for about 2 years, and finally convinced these four to go on camera and do it. They were very reluctant to be in the spotlight, and I'm so happy people are watching it.
Well, they were reluctant to do what this documentary was born out of, correct? Which was a panel that you emceed, you hosted at the owners meeting a couple of years ago. Is that correct, Jane?
Yeah, it actually all started. It's kind of a funny backstory, which I think any football fan would appreciate. So Virginia McCaskey, Halis McCaskey, is 96 years old, right? She is, but most every sports writer I've asked has said she has watched more professional football than anybody who is alive on the planet today. So I thought, wouldn't that be a fantastic documentary? She's 96, and I didn't think twice about it when I called NFL Films to say, are you guys interested? And they said, did she say yes? So her son, George McCaskey, said she likes to email, so I email her. So I put together this very professional-sounding email and how I would be doing the interview, and we know each other, and it won't be that big a deal. We'll use a lot of great archive footage of her dad, and I knew she'd be a little shy, but I had no idea. I sent it on a Saturday night, September 2017, Monday afternoon, I got an email back from Virginia McCaskey saying, dear Jane, I was so surprised to see your email in my inbox on game day. So I sent it on a Saturday night. She picked it up on the morning of the game. The Bears did not win.
Uh-oh.
And she sent it back and said, not on your life. Do I want to be on television? So from there we started, and I spoke to all four of them multiple times. And finally, Pat Rooney said, we give up. We cry uncle. Let's just do a little panel together. And so we put them together on that panel, which you see in the movie. And then once that happened, Virginia came up to me afterwards and said, I get it. I get that people want to hear what we have to say.
Of course.
I'll do whatever you like. And I said, would you like to make a movie? And she, as only Virginia can do, with a twinkle in her eye, said, email me. I did, and we were off and running last season to shoot it.
So what did you learn? What did you learn, Jane? Because you've seen a ton of football, and you've been around the power base of the league. What did you learn from these four great ladies?
Well, you know, it's just anything. We have Peanut Charles Tillman talking in this film about anytime you have a chance to spend time with people who are in their 80s and 90s and who are still so vibrant and thriving, you know, pull up a chair and listen, because there is so much to learn. From them, commitment, dedication, I think taking the long view, not getting sweating the small stuff. They have incredible senses of humor. But really what I thought was so interesting is, first of all, I knew they were big-time fans and competitive, but I had no idea the depth of their passion for this game and their intensity. So we had a lot of negotiations with the film's crews trying to get inside their suites to film them at home, those kinds of things. Mm-hmm. They did not want anything to distract them from the game. And they come from very, very different backgrounds. But and I was really just struck, though, about what ties them together. Not only their passion and their intensity, but just how grateful they are, how dedicated they are to their communities. They look at this, to have a football team in an American city, as an honor, all of them. They said it multiple times, we don't take this for granted. We are all about protecting this legacy, which I thought at the end of the day was a really kind of beautiful message. And I think and I hope that comes through in the film.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live, or download The Rich Eisen Show app.